Hi, this is a video just to show you a bit more about how content can be published on Wikipedia, the free and open encyclopedia. When you create your account, you have a username and a talk page where people can leave you messages. And the most important one for our purposes is your sandbox. Your sandbox is, as the name suggests, where you draft content. It's your personal play area on Wikipedia. Because although Wikipedia is a work in progress and will always be a work in progress as we try to document the world's knowledge, if it's just half an article or half a paragraph, that's too much. So what we do is we draft content away from the Wikipedia main space in what's called the user space. And here is my username, uinvid4, and a subpage of that is my sandbox. This title line is always what is searchable in Wikipedia. So no one should be editing any page related to my user account except for myself. So I'm gonna be able to draft content here in peace. When you click on the link, your sandbox should open up with these drop-down menus, which are what's called the visual editor interface. There are two ways of editing Wikipedia. The source editor makes use of HTML markup language and is a bit more codey in nature. So it's the older way of editing Wikipedia. Most people, I think, will benefit from using these drop-down menus, which are much more like using WordPress or Microsoft Word type documents, where you can write text on a page and then amend it and add links and add citations and bullet points, etc. just by selecting these drop-down menu options. So you can use that magic pen symbol, which is next to this publish changes button, because all a Wikipedia page is really about editing. Clicking edit to go into any page, and clicking on the blue save button to save the edits so that they become live and viewable. And I should mention at this point that although it says publish, it really just means it's saving the page, and it's saving it in your user space. So I wouldn't worry about sort of your edits going live in the main Wikipedia article space. Okay, so as long as you have these drop down menus and you are in the visual editor, like I say, you can use this pen to make sure you go into visual editor. Then you can start adding content by typing text down below these boxes. And paragraph size of writing is the normal size of writing on Wikipedia, but we often like to split text up into headings. So you can just highlight text and change it using the visual editor into the headings. So what I've got added a bit earlier is just some guidelines, because a lot of people have a go at Wikipedia editing, but they don't know the sort of behind the scenes policies and guidelines that Wikipedia has about making sure that we are adding fact-checked information. So although Wikipedia is the encyclopedia that anyone can edit, what people don't realize is that you have to cite what you write. And Wikipedia is not just a telephone book of listing every single person or every single thing in the world. We do have a policy of notability and a policy of verifiability and a policy on reliable sources. So if for any reason you're not writing based on reliable published secondary sources and the information that you add isn't verifiable from those sources, and it's not written from a neutral point of view, or it doesn't meet Wikipedia's threshold for notability, then the content will either be removed or the entire article may be nominated for speedy deletion, which can be frustrating. I do understand, but this is just to let you know what the main criteria that you should be following when you're writing a page. So where the main things to bear in mind when you're writing new articles on Wikipedia is to write in your own words. Every page on Wikipedia has this license at the bottom, where text is available under the Creative Commons Attribution Share Alike license. Now that license permits that information to be shared and reused elsewhere. So copyrighted material cannot be added to Wikipedia. So even close paraphrasing counts as copyright violation. So even if I copied whole chunks of the Guardian newspaper into this draft space, with the idea that I was going to work with it to sort of like craft my article, that's still copyright violation. This sandbox page is still part of Wikipedia and still has to abide by the Creative Commons Attribution Share Alike license. It's also why content on Wikipedia spreads across the internet and is used by Facebook, YouTube, Google, Siri, Alexa, as the largest open education resource in human history. Having that free information to be reused and shared is quite a powerful thing. So what's right or wrong or missing on Wikipedia really matters, but you do have to write in your own words. And the second thing is to avoid peacock words. And peacock is anything that's a bit too flowery or aggrandizing. So talking about a topic as if it's the best thing since sliced bread, the most significant, the most important, the most fabulous. We need to strip back your writing to a much more factual, pared down, encyclopedic style. And similarly, we avoid weasel words. And these are things that are unattributed or too general or too vague in nature, where you're mentioning it's widely believed that, or generally they are regarded as that. Well, that's contestable because you haven't provided any information about who states that or what states that. So we need to be a bit more specific and guarded and factual in our language and pare it down to what we can definitely say. If you want to add information like that, you should really attribute where that information's coming from or who stated that or what body stated that. Quotes are fine as long as they're short in nature and attributed. So again, write factually and with an encyclopedic style, which is a different style of writing to, you know, news releases or promotional releases or academic essay work. It does have its own style. And what you can do is have a look at existing articles on Wikipedia to try and see how they use language and pare the writing down. Another aspect is that you have to write with a neutral point of view. You can cover different schools of thought, but the idea is not to sort of have an undue bias or provide too much weight to one particular school of thought. Although, you know, there would also be the counter argument about not providing equivalence if they're like 80% of the world believed a certain school of thought and only 10 to 20% believed another school of thought. The idea wouldn't be to provide those ideas with equivalence, but what we're looking for is a sort of literature review and an objective point of view. And with medical content, we are looking to provide a medical consensus of the health information. So there's a stricter policy on biomedical content where we make use of review literature from the last 5 years. So recent review literature that establishes a medical consensus before information can be added about health topics. Health topics and other topics are, it's important that all the topics are written accessibly so that anyone in any part of the world can understand that article, even if they've got no background in science or medicine or anything else that you're writing about. You shouldn't need to be an expert to understand a Wikipedia article. So you need to structure and split your article into sections, into these headings that I've showed you earlier. And you can have a look at some other articles on Wikipedia to check what kind of headings they use, because depending on what you're writing about, there is kind of a set guide to the types of headings you might want to use. Whether it's a novel you're writing about, it might have a section on themes, or how it was received when it was published, or the background to the novel. Or if it's a biography, it might have their early life and education first and move into their later career and achievements, later life, death and legacy. And so it's worthwhile having a look at exemplar articles to give you an idea of how to split it up into section headings. Importantly, we do want anyone to understand your article. So if you're going to use any jargon terms, it's important to explain what they mean the first time they're used. And because Wikipedia wants you to jump down the rabbit hole of knowledge and help your understanding, if you mention another topic that has an English Wikipedia page, it's important to have a little blue wiki link to that page. And links are really easy to add. So I can click on that link drop down, and it will look for a page with that title. And you only need to link something the first time it's mentioned in your article. So if Wikipedia is mentioned multiple times, then you only need to link it the first time. And the main body of your article is all about links to other Wikipedia pages. We don't add links to external websites in our article. But if we did want to, we could add the most pertinent external links in their own section at the foot of the page in a short bullet pointed list. We don't want Wikipedia to become a link farm. So if you can add 5 to 8 of the most relevant links to external websites in a section called external links at the foot of the page, that's normally what we do to cover external links. So all the links above that are to Wikipedia pages. And finally, the most important thing, cite what you write. And that's what a lot of people don't understand, is although Wikipedia is the website that anyone can edit, you have to cite what you write. And unreferenced, poorly referenced content will be removed. So you do have to add citations from reliable published secondary sources. So by that we mean information that is published outside of Wikipedia. So in books, respectable books that have that are well regarded as and have a reputation for fact checking and accuracy. So books, textbooks, news from quality news organizations and sites. So we're talking like broadsheet news more than tabloids. So have a look at the broadsheet news and that sort of sliding scale of trust. Avoid the sort of yellow press, and avoid more of the social media posts. Avoid sort of Facebook or Twitter as your source of information, unless your article is actually referencing something that happened in the news related to that, those social media posts. Blog posts tend to be another thing that we avoid, although that's an evolving relationship. Some university blogs are very high quality and have editorial oversight. But generally, blog posts are, we're slightly more skeptical of those because they can be an unstable link. They might be there one day and then gone the next, and they might be more opinion based than factual. And we do need information to be reasonably consistent in terms of the information being fact checked, and having editorial oversight and having a reputation for accuracy. So reliable published secondary sources, textbooks, books, quality news, broadsheet news, high quality magazines, The New Yorker, etc., New Scientist, and also scholarly journals, quite important. That in editorial oversight, and that we do want experts contributing to Wikipedia. So cite what you write, you make a statement, and then you can add a citation after the full stop. And if you have a web URL or a DOI or an ISBN number or a PubMed identifier, if you have any of those, you can use this automatic citation generator. So you just place your cursor after the full stop, cite, paste it in, and it hit generate, and that'll create a numbered citation that when you save the page will create a reference at the foot of the page. And if you don't have any of those four things, you can use the manual citation generator, which will ask you for first name of author, last name of author, title, etc., etc. Importantly, if you're using books, it's important to add the page number. And if it does have a DOI number, if it is a scholarly journal, for example, a digital object identifier number, I would use that instead of the URL, because DOIs are much more stable, a link, and much provide a lot more rich metadata. And I can add a PubMed identifier here, just to show you how that works. Here's a PubMed number I know about, and it's pulling in some really rich metadata that has a DOI number and the PubMed number I just added. And then I can insert, and there's a numbered citation. And if I save the page, it'll create the reference at the foot of the page. So cite what you write, really important. All the way through your article, add citations after the full stop. That's what we'll be checking. We don't want, and your article will be reviewed before it goes fully live. It'll go on to the article space, but someone will be in New Page Patrol, will have a look and see if you're covering all of these five areas, that it's well cited, written accessibly, neutral point of view, avoids peacock words, and is written in your own words. And all of this information you can find on Wikipedia pages, like our page on Notability. And this you can find by searching here, behind the scenes. It's called a project page because it has that Wikipedia colon information. And Notability is the one big hurdle, I would say, for new editors. And it's a test by which editors reviewing your article going live on a page decide whether it warrants its place on Wikipedia. Because like I say, we're not supposed to be a yellow pages of listing everything. We're supposed to be listing important, notable, significant topic coverage. So it's worthwhile, while you're writing your first article, to have a look at the general Notability guideline, the GNG. And this is what it says, significant coverage. So we're looking for a depth and breadth of information out there in the world about your topic. So not just scant mentions, but is there a depth and breadth of coverage out there in reliable published secondary sources? So, and this one is an important one. The sources that you consult and cite in your article should be independent of the subject. So if it's a writing about a book, often there's a lot of information about the author might have their own website. That's not independent. They might have their own publisher will have a website. Again, not independent. And they might have an agent as well, that not independent. So those are three sources that while they do provide a certain amount of information, they are not really independent of the subject. So it's better if we can really steer the coverage to news or scholarly articles or textbooks or books that talk about the book that we're trying to write about. So yeah, avoid and steer when you're writing about something to sources that are really truly independent of the subject. So worthwhile having a look at the GNG to before you get going. There is a page on reliable sources about what constitutes a reliable source, but your basic guideline is, does it have a reputation for fact-checking and accuracy? Is it considered reliable? Is it published elsewhere? And either online or in print? And does it have any editorial oversight? That's often a very useful measure. But does it have that reputation for fact-checking and accuracy? And is it a secondary source? We don't tend to use reliable primary sources as sources on Wikipedia. We're willing to wait for someone else to write about that primary source. So if I go back, there is a page on neutral point of view and also a manual of style. So manual of style is what you can have a look at again at this WP manual of style. It shows you about how to write the lead section of an article and words to watch out for, etc. And basically, it gives you an idea of how we try and keep pages consistent in terms of dates and numbers, abbreviations, capital letters. But so there is, you can definitely have a look at that. But what I would also say is you could have a look at an exemplar article. Wikipedia's front page is always one click away by clicking on the logo. And it always has a featured article on the front page. This changes daily, but the featured article is always considered one of the best articles on Wikipedia. So today it's Megalograptus. But you can click on the little star that takes you to all the featured articles on Wikipedia. Again, that is findable by having a look at the top line and placing it here in the search. You can find it there. But so there's 6,000 featured articles that are community reviewed and considered the best of the best quality on Wikipedia. So if you're looking for a good exemplar related to what you want to write about, whether it's in physics or astronomy or food and drink or music or anything else, you can have a look into those articles. And you, if you sort of basically follow how they've laid information out, that'll keep you right about the kind of headings they use, the kind of language they use, and how they use links and how they have citations and images all the way through. Okay, so featured articles are good examples to follow. And if you're not sure how much is needed to write a new article, because featured articles tend to be very long and quite well referenced with bibliographies as well, then what we tend to say is, can you write 50 words or more to get an article started? Draft 50 words or more in your sandbox and back up the content. Cite what you write with reference to three or four more reliable published secondary sources. So just a few sentences in your sandbox, and then you can publish it and create new pages like Thrawn Janet. This was a page that didn't exist on Wikipedia until someone sat down and wrote it. And that person, it was Jill Hamilton at the National Library of Scotland, at one of our Edinburgh Gothic events. So this is a short story written in Scots, one of the few written by Robert Louis Stevenson in Scots language, and it's a dark tale of satanic possession. And happily, it's now got this image that we got. It was an open licensed image that was found on Flickr, taken from an illustration that was on Internet Archive. We have the actual text of the story in Wikisource, which is our free digital library that has longer texts in it, all open licensed. So you can read the whole story on there in 100% searchable HTML. And happily, it's now a nice link added to this navigation box among all of his other books and stories. These are all English Wikipedia links. And Thrawn Janet's in there. So this is editable as well. So it helps curate the whole topic area and allow someone to really find out about that. But why I'm mentioning Thrawn Janet is, if you look at the edit history, and the edit history just shows you the whole edits that happen to a page over time, and they're all saved in permanent links. So no matter what change is made, we can undo unhelpful edits, or we can compare different page versions with other dates and times to see how the page has changed over time. And there's even a page views option in here that will show you how many people have viewed the page since it was created. 20,000 people. 20,000 page views since it was created back in 2016. That's impact. But if I go back down to the very first time when Jill wrote the article, click on that 13th November, that's what we're talking about. This is enough to get the ball started on Wikipedia. The title of the page in bold in the first line, and a contextual sentence making it very clear what the article's about and making sure that it really makes its case about why it's notable for inclusion on Wikipedia. We have links to other English Wikipedia pages. And importantly, we've got the citations after the full stop from reliable published secondary sources that people can then verify after they've read the article, or if they read any sentence on the article, they can verify, where did that information come from? How can I check it? Because that information, you don't cite Wikipedia, but you can cite the sources it uses if they're reliable, credible sources. And it's a good rule of thumb for anything you read on the internet is check, verify the information. Where are they getting that information from? But that is enough to get an article started. Just two or three sentences with three or more reliable published secondary sources to get the article started. And we're looking for that depth and breadth of coverage to demonstrate the topic is remarkable, significant, important, or notable for inclusion. So worth having a look at that notability guideline, because that's the main hurdle that you're gonna come up against when you're trying to demonstrate that your article belongs on Wikipedia. One final policy that you should be aware of is the strict conflict of interest policy, where editors should not be writing content about themselves, their friends, their family members, their close colleagues, or their employer. Anything where your impartiality as an editor could be called into question, even if you think you're objective. It's better if an independent editor writes the article, especially where there is a very close relationship or a paid relationship involved. And any conflict of interest really needs to be disclosed so that the transparency and integrity of Wikipedia can be maintained, and also yourself as an editor. So often when you have a conflict of interest, you can add it as a note on your user page to say, I work here, I am a member of this. And then transparency is key, because if it's hidden and discovered later, that leads to problems and can mean certain institutions or IP addresses or editing accounts are blocked or barred from editing. There is a conflict of interest notice board on Wikipedia where edits can be suggested to editors who are going to be independent of the subject. Alternatively, you can curate a list of reliable public secondary sources, maybe in a Word document or an Excel sheet or Google sheet, so that you can provide that to an independent volunteer editor to work with. And if your topic isn't one that's going to get garnered or galvanized an independent volunteer editor to be found, then drafting content is acceptable as a last resort, I would say. It really should be an independent editor, but if you can't find one, then the main thing would be that you need to get someone to review your draft. Like, you could post a link to your draft on the conflict of interest notice board so that an independent editor can review it before it goes anywhere near the main article space, so that transparency of motive and transparency of intent is really important here. So you need to make sure you disclose any potential conflict of interest. Okay, so when you do have your text, your Thrawn Janet sized amount of text or more ready to go, what you need to do is migrate your content into the Wikipedia main space. So what I need to do is save the page with added text for a new article here. And I'm a new editor, I've only recently created this account, I'm not allowed to migrate this content directly into Wikipedia's main space. What you'll find is that if you create a new account, you only have this option, this blue button, to submit your draft for review. So when you've got your content looking like this, or maybe longer, like one of these longer featured articles, then you can submit it and someone from the article for creation Q team will have a look at the article and give you feedback about whether it meets the sort of criteria of writing your own words, avoiding peacock words, neutral point of view, written accessibly, citing what you write, etc. The downside of this is that there is a bit of a backlog to the queue, so it might get reviewed quite quickly within a day or two, or you might find that you're waiting 10 days or 3 weeks to get feedback. And if it doesn't immediately meet all of these criteria, you might get the knockback until it's further worked on. That's why I would say have a look at an exemplar article and make sure your article is pretty well close to one of these existing articles before you submit it, so that you're not disappointed further down the road. But when you have had your account for more than 4 days and made 10 saves or more, then you will get a new menu option that will appear next to the view history. And at the moment I don't have that, so if I click on preferences, I can show you how many edits I've made, or how many times I've saved my page. 6 times. So I'm considered a new user and I've only made 6 saves to a page, therefore I'm not yet permitted to move my content directly into the Wikipedia main space. So 4 days and 10 edits or more, and then you should be what's called confirmed editor status, and that then means you will get the option to move your content into the Wikipedia main space. So I'm just fast forwarding a bit to show you what happens when you've had your account for more than 4 days and made 10 or more saves to pages. then what you get is this more menu next to the search bar. And this is kind of the recommended way to publish pages on Wikipedia. While you're still learning the ropes, I would recommend you get a bit of feedback on your article by submitting your article to the Articles for Creation review queue. But after that, I would say you can just use this more menu, and what you do is you just click. You make sure your article looks like a Wikipedia page. It's got the title in bold, that it's got some wiki links, that it's got a references heading, and it's got citations that when you save the page become references automatically at the foot of the page. But once you've got all that ready to go, then you can use the more menu, hit move, and basically moving it into the Wikipedia article space is just a question of changing these information in these three boxes. So at the moment, my page is in my personal user space on Wikipedia in my sandbox. So if I want to move it to the main article space on Wikipedia so that others can read it, then I select article, and I then have to change the title of the page to what I want the article to be called. Now, if there is already something on Wikipedia with that same title, then I would add a little disambiguation to explain what it was. Or if it was a person, I would explain what their job role was if there was someone else with the same name. If there wasn't, just go with their name. So you put the title of the page there, and the last one is, why are you putting a new page in Wikipedia? Because you've researched and written a new page. And maybe if you want it reviews, please, can this be reviewed? As I am a new editor. And then move, and then what happens is it will move the contents of your page into Wikipedia, where a new page patroller will come along and check quite quickly that it's laid out the way we would expect, and follows all of the main tenets that I've mentioned here. If it doesn't, then it'll either be moved to draft space so that you can work on it, or if it's looks nothing like a Wikipedia article or has lots of significant problems with it, then it'll be nominated for speedy deletion. But if it passes all of these tests and looks like a Wikipedia article, neutrally written in your own words, links to other pages, citations all the way through, and it importantly, it passes the Wikipedia general notability test, and that is the main hurdle for most new pages, then it will be a new article that people can read and discover on Wikipedia. And it's at that point that all you need to do then is maybe add some categories at the foot of the page, and you can edit to go in it. And categories can be added from this three horizontal lines menu next to the visual editing bar. And you can add more categories here. And I would have a look at other pages on Wikipedia to see suggested categories. If it's black, if it comes up as a black link, then it's found it. If it comes up as a red link, astronomical page, it's not found it. It doesn't exist, so I can bin it. We don't need to add categories that don't exist. So categories are only added once you've published a page. And The other thing we should probably do is think about other articles that ought to link to our page, because at the moment all your links hit in the article are outward, and they're, in order for the article to be truly discoverable, you want all of the most relevant pages to link to your page, so that there's a two-way linking going on. And if you're not sure what that looks like, you can, or what pages to add links to, you can type the name of your article into this find link tool, edwardbetts.com find link, and it will try and look for pages on Wikipedia that mention that page title, with the idea being that if other articles on Wikipedia are mentioning your page, then they should have a wiki link to your new page as well. So you can have a look and see if these are relevant links. View article, and then make sure there is a, you can go into it and check that it's got a blue link. We need to have the link in the main body of the article. But if you you can find other links in this using this find link tool, because there's loads to check, and if we can find it, then we can make it super discoverable and add links to and from other pages. And there you go, that's how you get a page on Wikipedia.